There are several programs built into the 7531 that the other programmable 7 Series MSD ignitions do not have. The most talked about and benched race programs are the Slew Rate Rev Limiter and the TimeBased Rev Limit map. Both of these features are primarily used on drag cars that have extreme amounts of power, but have a small tyre or limited suspension modifications. It almost seems easy these days to make killer power, but knowing how to harness it is the real challenge. For years, racers have been retarding the timing on the hole shot to kill power on the launch, but these new features allow you to work with RPM instead of timing. In short, you can program and tune the ignition to help get the power to the ground. This sounds easy, but it will take some testing and tuning to get things set properly. The Slew Rate Rev Limiter allows you to program the rate of engine acceleration for each gear. For instance, if you set a limit of 1000 RPM for Slew in first gear, the engine will not accelerate faster than 1000 RPM per second. The menu tree of the ProData software allows you to easily set a slew rate for each gear. To determine and set slew rate, let's check back in with Joe.
To set the slew rate, we're going to use the data acquisition. This will help us determine the rate of acceleration in each gear. Now, to determine the rate of acceleration, open up a file, pick a nice clean line, hit your space bar, enter that number, which is 5225 in your low RPM. Choose another point, 6715, and your time is 0.41 seconds. Your rate of acceleration in low gear is 6334.
The slew rate is an amazing tool, but there's more to it than just setting an RPM rate. There are also adjustments that you have to set that have to do with your specific engine in order to compensate for crankshaft deflection and timing variances. Every engine is different and must be tuned accordingly. Remember, the help menu on the ProData software will help guide you through these settings. There is a second tuning tool in the 7531 that traction-challenged small tyre and drag radial cars prefer. A time-based rev limiter. This map allows you to chart a rev limit in 100 RPM increments based on time. For every tenth of a second, you can have a different rev limit, so in the end, you can have a useful rev limit curve to help keep the tyres planted. An important point to mention is that neither the slew or the time-based rev limiter are going to make your run any faster. Anytime you hit the rev limiter, your performance is going to be affected. However, these features may help you make a good pass on a questionable track. Okay, let's take a look at the time-based rev limit map. First, open your software and highlight the rev limit chart. Click on the line dot in the corner and we're going to pull that RPM point down to 3,400 RPM at zero time. When you launch, the engine RPM will be at this RPM. Next, we went up to about 2 seconds in the run and added a dot by right-clicking the mouse and positioning it at about 1.8 seconds at 8,300. It will now take 2 seconds for your engine to accelerate from 3,400 RPM to 8,300 RPM. We next added a dot at 12 seconds and bumped the rev limit up to 8,800 for the remainder of the pass. The first second or two is the most important for a drag car, so you can get into more detail and add more dots early in the time. Here we added another dot and set an RPM point of 6,700 at 1.2 seconds. Next, we added another dot at about half a second and at 4,700 RPM. You can add dots to make a smooth curve to match the launch characteristics of your car. One really cool trick is to open your data acquisition file to use actual run data. Open the trace analysis box of the rev limit chart, then go to the history file and open the trace box there. Locate the RPM data and then click and drag this data into the trace box of the rev limit chart. You'll see the RPM file come up on the chart. Next, you can add dots and draw a rev limit chart that mimics the actual data that came from the history file. Very tricky and very effective.